Hi, I'm Chris from Dynojet. Today we're going to talk about pressure-based tuning or manifold absolute pressure-based tuning. For years at Dynojet, we've been using the Power Commander to make adjustments based off of two inputs, RPM and throttle position. For those two inputs, we would output a fuel change. With the popularity of forced induction vehicles, i.e. turbocharged or supercharged engines, it's now more appropriate for us to tune based off of manifold absolute pressure, as throttle position and manifold pressure might not be necessarily linear. We need a way to adjust the fueling based off of the airflow going into the engine, and we do this by measuring the manifold absolute pressure, and we use that for our fuel table adjustments. In this video, we're going to cover some of the various units of measure for pressure, how to convert them. We're also going to discuss absolute versus relative pressure. I'm going to show you how to input and configure your pressure signal into a Power Commander PTI or CMD Marine. And we're also going to show you how to create a fuel table that is based off of your pressure signal. Now, there are several different units of measure used for pressure. Predominantly what we see is pounds per square inch, pascals or kilopascals, bars and millibars, or inches of mercury. Here at Dynojet, we predominantly use kilopascal and PSI, pounds per square inch. We can convert any unit of measure to any other unit of measure. For example, 14.7 pounds per square inch is equal to 100 kilopascals, which is also equal to 1 bar, which is also equal to 1,000 millibars. This is convenient because this just so happens to be the absolute pressure of the atmospheric air at sea level. Also, 1 pound per square inch is equal to 6.9 kilopascals, which is equal to 69 millibars. 1 PSI is also equal to 2.036 inches of mercury. Now, we have two ways to look at pressure. We have relative pressure, which is in relation to our atmospheric pressure, and we have absolute pressure, which is the same at all altitudes, all elevations, all atmospheric pressures. When we're looking at a boost gauge, we're used to seeing a positive value when the intake plenum is boosted and a negative value when the intake plenum is under vacuum. If we were looking at that same pressure as absolute, it would always be positive. Zero absolute pressure would be a total vacuum, which is only achievable in outer space. Here in this chart, we can see the relationship of elevation to atmospheric absolute pressure in PSI. For example, at sea level, our atmospheric absolute pressure is 14.7 pounds per square inch. If we happen to be at the top of a mountain where the elevation was 6,000 feet above sea level, our atmospheric absolute pressure would be 11.78 pounds per square inch. For watercraft, we offer the Dynojet CMD Marine. If the watercraft happens to be originally equipped with a turbocharger or a supercharger, we actually have connections to the stock manifold absolute pressure sensor on that watercraft. For the Power Commander, all Power Commanders will have an optional analog input that can be used for boost pressure on the wire terminal strip at the top of the module. We also offer the Power Commander PTI. PTI stands for pressure temperature input, and we make PTI Power Commanders for vehicles that are commonly getting equipped with turbochargers or superchargers. The PTI Power Commander comes with a Bosch 3-bar map sensor that also happens to have intake air temperature referenced. In the units, we look at pressure pre-configured in the units as absolute PSI. If you want to convert that to relative PSI, it's quite simple. So here we are in our Power Commander 5 software, and we're currently connected to the Power Commander 5 PTI unit. If we want to see our current pressure configuration, we'll go to Power Commander Tools, Configure, Pressure Input. Here in the PTI unit, we can see that we already have configurations present. This configuration is showing absolute PSI. In other words, a quarter of a volt equals 1.59 absolute PSI, 4.75 volts from the map sensor equals 44.52 absolute PSI. If we wanted to convert our pressure configuration to, say, relative pressure in relation to our current atmospheric pressure, we would simply subtract the atmospheric pressure quantity from these current values. So let's say, for example, I am at sea level and my current absolute pressure is 14.7 psi. I would simply subtract 14.7 from these values. So 44.52 minus 14.7 is equal to 29.82 psi. So I'll type that in. 1.59 minus 14.7 is equal to negative 13.11. So I'll type that in. Now I have my pressure input configured to show relative PSI at sea level. Click OK. Now if we want to add pressure-based fuel tables or ignition tables to our tune, we can go to Map Tools, Pressure Tables, Add Fuel Table. That's going to automatically bring up the pressure table setup. In the pressure table setup window, we can select how many columns we want inside of our pressure-based fuel table and what we want those columns to be. Keep in mind, I've now changed the pressure to relative. So if I want to see a table that shows negative pressure and positive pressure in relation to my atmospheric pressure, I might want to have a table size of 11. I want my rightmost column to show, we'll say 20 psi. Our leftmost column, perhaps negative 20 psi. We can interpolate everything in between, and now we have a pressure table that shows negative 20, minus 16, minus 12, minus 8, minus 4, 0, 4, 8, 12, 16, and 20. Click OK. And now we have a pressure-based fuel table in our map file with those specified columns. I can also do the same for ignition tables. Now I have an ignition table that will advance and retard the timing at various pressures. If I were setting up AutoTune, I can add AutoTune tables. Now it's going to ask me if I want my AutoTune style to be based off of throttle position or pressure. I really want a different air-fuel ratio at any given pressure, so I'm going to select to tune to AutoTune based off of pressure. So here I have my target AFR table and my trim table for AutoTune. If I have this vehicle running under vacuum or atmospheric pressure, I might want to adjust to an air fuel ratio of say 13.0. But as I increase the boost, I actually want my air fuel ratio to be richer and richer. So at 4 pounds of boost, I might target 12.7. Under 8 pounds, we'll go 12.4. 12 pounds, 12.0. And then anything over that, we'll shoot for 11.5. Now I have a desired or a target air fuel ratio table that is based off of manifold pressure. As my manifold pressure increases, my desired air fuel ratio gets richer. Now that we understand manifold absolute pressure and how to configure and set it up in your Power Commander 5 or CMD Marine, you should be able to tune your forced induction engine.